Just come in. Hey everybody, this is the Priest versus Clinic game. We're waiting for one player from a Clinic to come back in. His name is Arrow. Once they're in, we're gonna start this game. Mantis has now also DC'd, but leaving all that aside, we're mostly covering the Team Kaipi here, but for now, since their next opponent is like two games behind, we'll go here. Borno will come off the stairs. We'll probably just go and co-cast a bit here. So I'm not completely on my own again. He can't do any stats now, so that's why. Good game, Kiza. Is it? I've actually... I don't know, Mantis. Actually. Do you know Mantis as well? I think he's the old... X game? No. The one of the CS teams. There's too many. I sometimes forget them.
I'm not sure what that is. So, like, where's the lobby? Oh. Is it up?
Yeah, it's up. You can just follow me. Just right-click on me, watch game. And then just join in. So. We'll just wait a bit for the game here to start. Let's see, where's Skype? See, Kaipi Dota. Are they actually putting up anything in the form of matches? No, they're not really doing anything with the thing. See, it's Bone 7. Let's check his profile for now. Did he win today?
It's really interesting for a player to change roles, considering he was playing offlane before. I suppose, and most of the heroes he's playing right now, he haven't been playing for a long while, like Morph yesterday, first time Morph, first time TA, or like second time or something.
But still, the Morph that game wasn't really, it didn't work out, I guess. No, no, what's it? Which game? What? Sunstrike?
Yeah. Wait, you haven't seen him poker yet?
Oh yeah, shit, you have no extra point. Yeah, sorry, my bad.
It's pretty overpowered, this patch.
I completely forgot that you're now gonna you get a one level advantage pretty much from the beginning. And you get double stats at level 25, right?
Yeah, it's pretty stupid. Like Invoker can win mid easily now, like
I know,
way easier than before.
You just get 1 point now in Wex, right? Yeah, Wex, and then you have Alacrity up and then you can just dominate your lane. That says Justice, he's a pretty strong freaking mid player. So, it's not gonna be that easy.
Click Arrow. So, where are these guys from?
Absolutely no idea. I know Priest is the old team by the English, they're like they're a CS team. I think Click is also CS. Actually, whoa, Bone, what the hell is he doing there? He's gonna go down here. Actually, that wave missed, but still. Yeah, that's a nice try, I guess. What?
Okay, he's trying.
Oh. Eat another tree, eat a tree! No, no, you idiot! He's gonna be found anyway now.
Come on.
If he actually ate the tree there, that would have been unexpected. Like the one that was looking up against. Maybe they can get... Nah, what the fuck, it's too fast. I went. No, he should have just eaten through the tree. It's full window now. I'll just make a fast tweet while we're doing this. Tell me if something's happening and I'll go there on my cam.
That sounds good.
You can just guess it while I'm typing. Say stuff. Talk
yeah,
about mid.
Well, talking about mid.
Yes.
Well, not sure what to say. Invoker will win this. That's pretty lame to say, but
talk about why he would win it.
Well, considering this, having Invoke at level 1 gives you a lot of advantage. You can harass the enemy at early stage, and you know, just get him down. And yeah, I'm not ready for this, but yeah, okay. Help me out.
So Hermit, well, you're pretty much correct, so it's just shitty hero to play against.
Yeah, he's just spamming Alacrity and
just putting in the damage. He's just waiting. That said, if Justice is able to get some levels, he might be able to just turn something around. Yeah, he's too fast on the Windrun. He has to wait for Alacrity to come out and then pop it. So he can dodge the damage coming out while Alacrity is up, because now Alacrity is up, and if he goes after him, now Justice can't do anything anymore. He just has to stay back.
15 seconds cooldown and 45 mana, which is ridiculous.
Yeah, it's... Also, the damage already is so high. Close to 70. That says Justice also has a lot of damage, of course, being a Wind Ranger. Now he does it better. Here, you see, it's popped, and now Invoke has to start running it the hell away. He doesn't really have mana, though, to use Power Shot, so he won't survive for now. Bone. Oh, this hasted Tusk is not making his life easy at all. Still no mana on the Wind Ranger, so can't really do anything against it. Yeah, it's gonna be okay.
I think someone told me that this patch, Lina's win rate has lowered down, I think. Considering, I don't know. Lina used to win a lot of matchups in mid, but not now, after this patch for some reason, although the hero is still the same.
It's more that other heroes have changed.
Yeah.
I think that's the biggest... that's actually the thing, yeah. So, I heard the Twitter sound here from you.
Oh, yeah. Gotta mute that.
So, okay, I think I'm all set up.
Slaughter is playing the juice game.
Seems to not be doing it too well, though.
The new tree jukes are really amazing, actually, but really confusing at the same time. I have to like play many times to really understand where to go.
Mm. I'm still confused about the raiding jungle when I'm playing myself. Invoker does not get the kill, just he's pretty low himself. These are nothing global yet to kill him. Yeah. The jukes have mostly turned into like pathways.
Yeah, like the one here near the camp.
Which camp? I can't see your thing now, right? You know that.
I don't know if you can see it on the minimap.
No, of course not.
Okay.
Because we're not in the lobby anymore, we're watching through Dota TV.
The Dire new camp. The one behind it.
Dire new camp, the one behind it? Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. It's also changed. And I was just trying to run away playing a game, and like I just kept clicking in the wrong place, and the hero kept going in and out because there is no way to go. Like there is no path.
Man, I always the ramps, the new ones in the jungle itself near the new pillar. I always forget where the old pillar was, so I always walk towards the old pillar to ward. I stand there for 1 minute, or not 1 minute, like a couple seconds, wondering where the pillar went. Doing like a 360 view around me, where the fuck is it again? That said, Bone is really... I've seen him play a lot on Slaughter, and this has so far been one of... Like, he's always played well on him. So far, it's not been doing too well. Just one CS and two deaths already. They're really doing a good job of shutting him down here. That said, it leaves a lot of space here for Gedrox to get his farm going.
Yeah, this Phoenix seems to be getting, let's see, yeah, well, he's level 4, we're 7 CS, so he's getting a better lane than Slaughter, that's for sure. Although there is a 3 bottom, just as 2, but they're not zoning him out, I suppose, as they're supposed to.
Also, they really can't, like, what's the lockdown? They need to shackle. If the shackle doesn't latch, he can just dive away. Okay, now this is the problem. Now he's latched, and he even used Incarus Dive just before it. Well, that doesn't matter so much. So he goes down. Oh, Bone. They have shards. Oh, but the shards doesn't block him in. And the crush is also perfectly timed. Seems they want to keep on ganking here.
Nice.
He should see his army here. There we go. Invis run. Justice, he has a pretty full ball. I would say just leave that for him and yeah, go for Giga. Have him set something up. It got pinged, there you go. He's getting it. I think he just got a clarity spotted, yeah. Now he can set up something, an arrow here. He doesn't have any vision of this. Giga has Invis. Getting in position! And there it comes. Yeah, this there's no way he survived from this.
Yeah, Shadow Shaman is also one of the heroes coming back this meta. I've seen him be picked lately a lot.
Why do you think he's getting picked more now?
Well, I'm not sure. There's something about the Serpent Wars that changed. Not sure what, but I think I heard someone say something about it.
Small area of splash damage.
Yeah.
I think that's a new one. And now it takes two hits to destroy them instead of having health.
You know, it's always been a strong hero when it comes to pushing. You can just avoid the team fights, just throw the wards to the tower or the racks and just run away. It was really squishy.
Yeah, my theory more behind it is that, what is it, the meta has turned more into this death ball five man push kind of thing. And you know, he's just this strong pushing hero as well. Still pretty strong lane support as well. That's kind of like what I think about it as well. You see also, what is it, Jakiro's, you see him sometimes pop up, and just the overall pushing heroes are getting stronger. And they're trying to go after Mantis here. He does have a doppelganger. They're trying to get it out of there, but at the same time, they're just going to turn this one around and bone. Oh no, Gedrox actually comes in, and your cooldown is not going to connect on him. And so far, pretty much everybody's still alive in the end. The Tusk will go down. And the gank by Priest will be successful, but they didn't take the hero that they wanted. Mantis will still be able to just walk away.
I'm surprised the Gyro rotated while the Shadow Shaman stayed on the safe lane. Yeah.
Guess we want to get level 6 with him pretty fast so they can push down the tower. Once you get level 6, maybe if they get a lucky rune again, they can go after Arrow. And then just push down the mid tower as soon as possible. So they can open up the jungle.
Yeah. I think the dagger on Slaughter will be a crucial item for this game. It's probably the initiator they have.
Problem is when he's not going to get it anytime soon. It's going to be like, was it the 16, 17 minute blink dagger? If it goes this way.
Yeah.
Maybe if they can take some towers, it will be faster. So it kind of depends on what Giga can do and how the team will do it. But the fuck is trying to go for him here, but I don't think he can kill him. No, yeah, Giga's just gonna TP out. There you go. At least get him out for now. Maybe if Stallcat was there faster. Yeah. You don't have it always going your way. Bonus, absolutely no CS, just 4. He can't even go jungle, that's the one problem with Slaughter. Over, let's say, Darkseer, Sand Tower, or anything else. They have like jungle options, and this hero absolutely doesn't.
Well, you can actually do that, but you would have to waste some gold on the Iron Talon. And you don't want to do that. I can just go and take a few creeps every now and then, considering you have Trunkle Boost, so you don't have to worry about the regen much.
Problem is though, it goes so slow. Your experience is going to be so little instead of just standing here and getting experience like this. But yeah, you at least get gold. Well, he's going to lose maybe something more here. Invisibility rune on Invoker. He's already back. I think they know. Bone has no idea of this Invoker standing here. Still 15 seconds. 10 seconds.
He's suspicious.
3. They're gonna see him now. Oh, did you what? Okay, while we're watching all of that, the Phoenix on bottom died. They're trying to get Stallcat now as well. This Nether Blast. Oh, this does so much. Eater Shock. Damn it, what's wrong with me? There is not a freaking Pugna. It's a Shadow Shaman. And they get a kill. In the end, they still get. Did anything here? Never mind. They just got the tower. That was what I was seeing there. It's now Bone. You're gonna try and Go after him. Oh, tornado, just clip him in the end. But oh, 13 HP. They need to get this one hit in. But he's juking and jiving. When is the Sunstrike coming out? Sunstrike in 8 seconds. Mantis, he is shackled up, but Justice can't go after him. It's too far in. Arrow, he's looking for Pwn. He's gonna find him as well. They're gonna get him. Invoker picking up the kill there. And now Justice is also pretty low. One Sunstrike can actually kill him off. Oh, a Bless is gonna connect. Mantis will go down from this. Even, especially with the counter on top of him as well. Arrow, Sunstrike is off cooldown for him, I think. Can't really see it. How much HP does Justice have? Ah, yes, too much now.
Well, that wasn't too bad. Soon they got the PL eventually. Here is what Shadow Shaman does. That's for the tower. Pretty easy tower.
Yeah. Really, if you just lose any kind of fight near your tower and Serpent Watch is still up, you pretty much just lose your tower anyway. Like, you just can't defend it anymore after a bad team fight. Or even just losing one or two heroes will already stop it. Arrow, yeah, he's gonna get hit by this one. Don't think they really want to push in now anymore.
So, what do you think Jadros will go for? Sanjay Yasha, Drums, or.
Jarva?
Great BKB.
I guess Sanjay Yasha would be okay. I don't think you want to go BKB right now. If then the game gets late, somehow then the Invoker can do whatever the fuck he wants.
Yeah.
Probably Sanjay Yasha would most likely be the best option for now. Maybe go for Dragonlance.
Dragonlance. I'm not sure if this item is actually worth buying on
Jarva?
Any hero.
On Jarva? You can just the Ogre Club plus Quarterstaff, you can always build it into other items.
Well, and it's really expensive, but it, I don't know, it would take a slot for me, like, in late game.
Yeah, but in mid game, you can just get the Quarterstaff, just maybe even drop that in base, or have it casual, and turn it back into a BKB. Like, you can do a lot with it. I think on a hero like Gyrocopter is probably one of the better ones to get it on. Because you want to build a BKB, and you usually also want to build a Butterfly. And you don't want to get your BKB too fast, or your Butterfly too fast. Nope, Mantis, he should be able to not get out from here. Nicely follow up with the Shaco Shot and Hex as well. Even the AA Blast coming through. I like the item on certain heroes. Most agility heroes, I tend to like it. Especially if you're ahead. But he's gonna go for the Yasha first. Phoenix almost has his Midas ready. Oh, they're gonna come in. Oh, the Serpent Watcher dropped down. But they can't really keep the control around there. The Watch still are doing whatever the fuck they want. Pwn will go down for now, but now comes out the egg, but it's out of position. His teammates are not near, and now the Grave has to be used on Dazzle. He walked aggressively forward on his own, gets a nice weave up. But really, can his team follow up on this? They already lost 4 across the map right now, because the Tusk also died somewhere. Now Arrow, yeah, he's gonna go down here. There's no way for him to escape from this. Where did the Tusk die? Oh, he died in the beginning. Okay.
Oh, yeah. I think he got shackled. I think as we go through more through 6.86, we're gonna see a lot of new heroes coming back. Especially for the jungle area.
Yeah, there are more camps, you mean, and you can utilize more?
Well, more heroes will, more jungle heroes will be picked. Like LC, for example, I've tried LC, you can pretty much get Dagger really, really fast right now if you have the Iron Talon. Like, probably by minute 7 or something, and you're not gonna have any kind of trouble before you can, I don't know, you can get a bit late.
Problem is, though, that if you. But then you're saying run LC as a full jungle hero or as lane into jungle?
No, full jungle.
Then you're left to get punished pretty heavily. That's the one problem. Like, you can lose your lane so hard if they just go full on aggressive and just go for this pushing lineup. And then just snowball from there. That's the one problem.
Yeah, that's true.
I like it more if you just put him in a lane, let's say for the first couple levels. So your supports also get a little bit then, and then once you have like enough, pretty much levels and gold to get some farming tool like an Iron Talon, and let's say level 4 or something, and then go into the jungle and leave the lane for the supports. That's a lot harder to punish it like that, because you always start off with at least a dual lane.
I've also been thinking about OD, wondering if there will be anything that happened to him, like if we're gonna see him as he's been changed, but I don't know.
I've seen him picked up a couple of times, but it still has the same problems as before. Like, there is this big drop where he's pretty weak in the, was it 15 to 20 minutes usually? And his ultimate has such a long cooldown that once you take one fight, he kind of has to farm in between the fights for like 2 minutes. And if the enemy team has low cooldown heroes, then you're kind of fucked. Because you're going to lose a structure then, especially if you lose that fight, you're going to lose at least one or two towers. Or a tower and rush or something along those lines.
So, you don't think OD will make a comeback after this change?
I think he will be picked up a bit more, but I think the success will be really skewered. Like, the one time it will be incredibly good, but the other time you're walking around with a useless hero. Oh, that weave misses. Still want to pursue this? Nah, they don't have anything to get him there. There you go, he just blinks out. Pretty fast blink here on Giga. Does Pony even have his? No.
Wow.
I'm farmed by your position 4. Oh my
well,
god.
Well, here's the initiation, you got it.
Now, yeah, this is really what they needed, the double initiation that they have now. Especially since Justice went for the Maelstrom here. Guess you want to deal with the illusions from the PL, as well as just having extra attack speed for the egg is always nice. Blast coming through, gonna connect, but there's not gonna be any follow-up. Really, you don't want to fight now. Just let him go. Yeah, there you go. If Pwn dies now, was it like 3-400 gold? 470 gold. He needs. What's the buyback? That's buyback. Death cost 240. Okay. It's not too big, but he should just farm one or two creeps.
Yeah, the Phoenix is getting a lot of farm too. Like.
With the A, yeah.
He's close to the Invoker.
Yeah, but was it? He has like 3k, or was it 2 point something k? Yeah. Put in the hand of Midas, so yeah. I think we have one of the priest gaming people in our lobby. Huh? There's an easy D-ward there coming out for Clink. Clinic. Yeah. Click? Click. Such a weird name.
Reminds me of the, like, I don't know. Do you know Vodafone?
What?
Mobile service provider.
Oh yeah.
It was called Click before.
Okay. I haven't heard of them. What's getting shackled? Oh, creeps are getting shackled. Let's see. We'll see now if he actually goes for his Agnes first, or he might opt to go back for the. Blink dagger first and just have this triple blink dagger initiation. I wonder how far they're ahead, or if they even are ahead for that matter. Priest is ahead. 7.5k or so. Ah shit, I should have actually just restarted the stream and put the delay off. It's okay though.
You know there's 70 punch games in the major so far. The qualifiers.
70?
Yeah.
Doesn't surprise me.
Yeah.
It's been picked up a lot more in the in pubs as well. His win rate also went up.
Yep.
Do you want to go for a fight here? Lick is pretty low, but he still has his ultimate. I don't think they can really go for this. No. Ultimates from priests are used right now, so I think they will just back off. They can at least defend again at the tier 2, like the ultimates, apart from maybe, yeah, apart from Serpent Wards, all the ultimates are pretty low cooldown. I guess Focus Fire level, yeah, Focus Fire pre-axe is also like a minute, but still. It's not too bad.
I want to see that the Sand King being picked more, just not sure how will the Sand King leaning, like. If you can't go woods, you're gonna be punished, like you said. It's under attack. It's pretty strong when you get the axe.
So who again on the Windranger?
Sand King.
Sand King. Well, there's no Sand King in the game though.
Yeah, I'm saying I want to see it being picked more.
Still good hero.
Now with the axe, you can pretty much stun across the screen.
You mean the Eden Lance or?
Yeah, without the Aether Lens, you can stun across the screen. With the Aether Lens, you can't even see the range of the stun.
So more of these heroes that have those kind of abilities. It's getting pretty ridiculous, some heroes with the Aether Lens. Just imagine if things like Potion Nova also be affected by that.
Oh yeah.
What? He still killed the AA. Okay. Illusion did the work there. There's also a way to kill people, I guess. Oh shit, I was typing in the chat, should not have done that. They're still looking here for more here. Bone, he's trying to run away here, but he just gets purged off. Getting slower and slower. Mantis does have a doppelganger in one, should probably use it to destroy the trees. Is he going the wrong way? He's going the absolutely wrong way. Tornado is late as well. Bone is actually able to TP out for now, he's back in the base. All safe and happy. See, none of the teams have really gone for Roshan yet. I guess Priest Gaming has by far the better rush lineup. Biel is such a terrible rush hero.
Yeah, that's true.
I don't really have minus armor against him either.
Well, the Phoenix is going for a Shiva's guard. He's almost have it.
He's pretty close, yeah.
I'm not really a fan of Phantom Lancer, to be honest.
Overall or just this patch?
Well, this patch, I think he can... He's not really strong in fights, or it's based on the game, actually. Because the game is pretty much based on you. So, yeah, he's also item dependent a lot. Not like Gyro, sure. With Gyro you can just...
Yeah, you have brown boots and you have your ultimates and then you're done.
Yeah, just get out a lot of damage. Radiant's middle tower has been denied.
Yeah, I don't know. I kind of feel the same this patch as well. Like, I've seen more PL games, but it takes so long for him to come online. And there's so many heroes that just... You know, enemy lineups tend to go at you at the point where you're kinda on your weakest. With all those death push things that is usually just before you get a diffuser or whatever, or just any kind of really useful item. Mm-hmm. Just before that, they come at your towers and then you're like, well, now I'm kinda fucked.
Yeah. You can really be pushed out of the lane really easy.
See, this is the last escape again. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified. Here we go. Some pushing bottom going on. Just typing a bit in the chat, guys. If you're not guessing from the lobby, it becomes all a lot more relaxed. You don't have the people in game that's listening, was it? Now they're like two game spectators. Let's say 50% listen to you and have you on, so. So then you still need to do something about the mic output in the Dota 2 client. It's still pretty bad.
I don't think it's really bad. I don't know.
My mic gets absolutely fucked up, and I know of more people as well.
Yeah, well, I think someone told me you had. They had mic issues, but not everyone in the last game.
Did someone say I had mic issues during the cast in lobby, or?
Yeah. But some people said that, some others. Some didn't, so I'm not sure.
If it was him, you maybe just need to up the force in your settings then, as well. If you can't hear the caster too well over the other sounds, it probably means that you have voice off or something, or really low in your audio settings. This is like gonna be the most boring build on the PL, pretty much there is. It seems as Inigata has been caught out. He doesn't have a 4 staff or the mana to get away from here. There you go, he's done. Anyhow, just to get back to the Mantis builder, I think this is so boring. Like, BOTs, Diffusal, going into Manta and already having Drums and Keylights. I don't know. Take a risk. Go for something fun. Get first item Basher or something.
We wouldn't be able to do anything with that.
It would be funny though. You get the Bashes from your main hero. Like.
Well.
Okay, MKB. Game.
Oh.
What? This is Shiva's.
Yeah. Shiva. Oh shit. The whole Shiva. That's nice.
Yeah, this is really nice for Priest here. We stream minions without your Shivas, he just essentially lost about 3.5k worth of of utility here. Radiant's top tower. I think, yeah, but I guess Clique are okay with just farming it up for now. There's no reason for them to go at him.
Yeah, but I don't know if this will go for late game. How will this go for Clique, considering they only have PL and Invoker to depend on when it comes to damage output?
And against Invoker, you just get a BKB. Invoker will just even die here. He tried to gank on Zenigata, but they were way too ready for this one.
Yeah. Also, Invoker is not as well farmed as the Windrunner. Like, even the Phoenix is far ahead from Invoker. So,
apart from the fact that all his money is in the career.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
Choose to go to Roshan.
Okay, this is something I've not seen in. Well, pretty much ever. Who the hell gets a Vanguard on Tusk?
Oh. Huh.
That's just weird. I'd rather get a Rod of Atos or something to help out your team and slow the others over getting a freaking Vanguard, because I don't really get why he's getting this, to be honest. I guess it's... I'll get Crimson against the Servant Wards. I guess that's the reason.
Well, you would just save the money for a BKB or something, considering there's a lot of stuns and disables on Priests.
No, I think it's... No, it's really for the Serpent Wards. They just neglect the damage from that, but what is it? 60 damage, it pretty much gets completely blocked.
All of it?
Yeah, pretty much. I think it's like, what's the block from guard active? It's like 60.
Let's see.
Here, let's see. Guards. Oh, 55. I got close.
Oh, wow.
This is pretty much the full block. What is it? Level 2 is 60 damage. Yeah. Level 3 is 75, so essentially, once he's level 3, you just get 20 damage, which is pretty neglectable. Even with 10, it's still 200, but still, it's not that much. Then you also have your own armor still kicking in, so. Would be like 10.
Yeah, I think the Vanguard is a really bad item. I haven't seen that item being bought actually lately a lot, although before in Dota, it was like. A core item on most of the heroes, even carries. Like, if you're gonna play Spectre, you'll buy it. Play PL, you'll buy it. Play anything, but that's not in Dota 2, actually. That is back in Dota 1. But the item has been the same for so long.
Oh, just this quick on the finger.
I think they should do something about the item so it would be bought much.
The Vanguard? It was. Yeah. It just depends on the hero. I don't think. Like this game, when you're against Witch Doctors and the Shadow Shamanist, I would say it's worth his money if you can build it into a Crimson. I just think the Tusk is not a good Vanguard carrier overall. Just the item itself, like once it's a Crimson Guard, yeah, then it does a lot for your team. But pre-death is not really worth a whole lot on yourself, because when you're initiating, you probably die anyway, even if you have a Vanguard.
Yeah.
So, that doesn't really help you there.
I think the overall item is not really good. I think it needs a buff or something. Like
what? Higher regen, more health, get some, was it, plus 15% magic reduction?
Well, more block. Or, more block would do it. Or you could just add something to it, like change that combination of the item and change something about it.
Was it if you but the problem then is that you're gonna see such a big resurgence of the Bristleback.
Oh, yeah.
Like, if you buff that item, Bristleback just becomes so much more viable.
Oh, talking of Bristleback, this Axe on Bristleback is pretty crazy.
Yeah, it's pretty much just guarantees you to have, what is it, the Warpath max stacks at all times.
Oh, so you don't have to actually click 5 times to get full stacks? Only one time. If you have 5 heroes and you click one time, you got the 5 stacks?
No, I mean you just walk around the map clicking your button all the time.
Oh.
You can pretty much just build what is the macro that just pushes the button every time it comes off cooldown. Just so you have the max stack. You just get a Shivers or something then next to it, or anything else that gives you some kind of regeneration for your mana, and then you just go crazy. Okay, there comes out the use, but there's a BKB on Gyrocopter if he wants to pop it. Nah, he just walks away. He doesn't care too much. This game has slowed down so much. None of the teams really willing to commit into anything.
Yeah. It's mostly Click playing safe. The same game.
Priest is trying to push. Oh, they seem to be going for the PL here. They found the real one. He has Doppelganger soon. They need to stop this one. Okay, Shekel comes out. That should stop him pretty much well. Oh, no, no. Doppelganger? Did Doppelganger kick out? Oh, that's a really nice ultimate over there. They're going to get the bone for now. Are they able to kill off the... Oh, yeah, they are with 3 people coming there. Are they going to go back in here? I don't think they can. I think Click needs to get the hell away. Arrow has his skills pretty much on cooldown. Should probably invoke Icewall to keep them out. There you go. He didn't invoke it, so they just start running in. Mantis. I still have Mantis. I can get out for now. Justice. He has no more mana. Now he is in trouble. He went too deep. But there's just the Aegis. Welcomes out. Ice as well. Gatherox. He seems to be willing to get out. Justice want to do the same. It's going to be slowed a bit, but should be able to get out. Arrow? He's going aggressive here. He can't invoke anything for now. Zenigata will be able to get out. And now he just gets turned around. After the... the grave is pretty nice in time, though. But still, they're going to lose a couple here. Arrow, yeah, there we go. He's going to go down as well. That's 2. I should have just let this one go. Be happy that they got the Aegis, but they wanted more.
Tough one. Not a lot of damage output from Click side.
Yeah. Invoker skills were on cooldown again, so every time they're on cooldown, dude, they should just stop doing that. What the hell is what the fuck doing? Now he's turned into a chicken. He doesn't have his ultimate. I don't get why he went that deep. Giga, Giga, he's gonna get out. Gedrox almost got system there. That almost went wrong.
Well, Invoker is still level 1. Is that how it's played? Because I'm not an Invoker player, so...
Explains it. Why the fuck didn't he level it up? I guess he's just doing like the tree spell Invoker or something, like what's it, Tornado EMP and then, what's the skill for it? Maybe Gold Snap or Deafening Blast. But yeah, if he was able to invoke a bit more in the fight, it could have actually changed quite a bit.
Yeah, he just got level 2.
Okay, now he does. He's a Nami. He's gonna get hit by this one. Is this an X upgraded one? He's still gonna die though. Grave was before it. This is X, right? No, not yet.
No.
Almost. It's a bit too fast. Serpent Warrants pops. No Crimson Guard just yet. So. At least able to destroy them pretty fastly here. BKB pulled by Gedrox. He really wanna get this Rex. Nothing really to stop him right now. So there's enough timing to get out as well. Tornado is gonna clip at least Justice for now, but I don't think they're still gonna follow up in this one. Shackled against the tree there. Oh, that's annoying. Best coming through, just gonna connect on Mantis for now. With that, they're just gonna TP out. Nope. Not gonna reach them.
That's an easy Rax.
Yeah, not even punished for it in the way back. Just the BKB charge, but that's okay. Was it 10? Oh, 9. That's still fine. I should talk to D2L after this game. Check what the matchups are for tomorrow and then maybe get a match going on the website.
This game?
I don't know who are in the round of 32, but maybe if there's like one good matchup, I can just get them, put it up. Put my stream next to it.
I know an admin, but...
I know as well. I know multiple ones. I know three. No, I know three of them. Ooh, Giga pops his BKB and he's like, eh, yeah, I'm a pretty goddamn firm to Shadow Shaman. They're gonna turn this around. Izanami's gonna go down first. They have the egg down. The egg goes, not gonna pop here. He's gonna go down first. Click, arrow has started running the hell away. I don't think Pwn is gonna find him, though. He's just the wrong way. Arrow will escape. That Shadow Shaman is just way too freaking farmed.
Shadow Shaman, then Invoker on top of the net worth. Like, there's like 1k, more than 1k difference between them. Kinda sad. You see the difference between Shadow Shaman and Wind. It's like, oh. Big difference.
Ooh. It's able to at least get off the Serpent Watch before he lost all of his mana. Yeah, they just can't do anything against it. This BKB was such a smart pickup as well. Just being able to secure a long leash shackle is just meets an extra kill. It's a lot better than usually you're gonna get was the Aghanim's, but this time around I like this one a bit more. Trying to go after Gadrox here, this should be able to do so. BKB is still on cooldown, so not really any way for him to survive through all of this. Mantis will be able to kill him off, but I think he will pay with his life for this one. Yeah, Pwn comes in now, and Stalkat, yeah, he's gonna at least return the favor for this one. But still, I think Priest has something to say about this. There's gonna be a TP in. This is gonna be... what the fuck? He can't really fight against Priest, against Justice here. What? Oh, he blinked back. No, what? I saw the snowball coming from Stalkat, but he wasn't next to Justice. I guess it was just a weird animation. Still not the Aghanim's. Oh, this is the Aghanim's one.
Yeah. Well, I think the BKB on Shadow Shaman was a good pick. Considering you can just jump and do whatever you want, no one will stop you.
Yeah, what is it? They just have one lane of Rex left. And tier 2 as well. Let's see, Roshan should be up almost. Yeah, there we go. Let's watch the magical moment of Roshan respawning. That's just so lovely.
He went out.
Here we go. He's gonna walk back in now. The spider senses were tingling. Actually, the next lobby is already up for Priest versus PR.
Oh, you wanna go?
Yeah, let's check it up. Let's check it out. Is the lobby up? Maybe the lobby is still loading. And okay, lobby's not up just yet, luckily. I think I just spoiled who won the game. The next lobby is not sure about who the hell is going to be playing in that one. We have absolutely no idea. We haven't looked at the brackets. Oh my god. This 5-minute delay is just too much.
Way too much.
Kinda sucks that we're forced to use it when we want to go into a lobby. Yeah, fuck it. I'm not going to care too much about my camera work. Just gonna use the edge pen like a scrap. Now what I really hate is when you with a bunch of those, a lot of casters, they just put the screen all so far out instead of just focusing on the fight. They just try to get everything in there, which just doesn't work. Here the egg is coming out, it will just be destroyed again, nothing to do about it. Mantis tries to walk in, Crimson Guard is finally popped, they're not getting a whole lot of damage here, so just zoom in quick. But yeah, I don't think this is gonna be anything good for Click here, so you're just gonna level 5 here most likely. Mantis, there you go. Could have hyped that one up, but...
Yeah. GG is gone. Yeah. I think about the camera thing, you actually want to get us... Like, you want to see what's happening, so you gotta get up.
Yeah, but the problem is they go out so far that they try to put so much in there that it actually doesn't... It just becomes less.
Well, yeah.
I know I've just seen those people.
Yeah, one scroll is fine this time. When you do two, you just...
You go too far.
Yeah.
And you also for yourself as a caster, you're gonna lose focus of what you're doing.